वेरी गुड डे माय डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट इफ स्टेटमेंट। लेट अस सी नाउ स्टूडेंट, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय इफ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पाइथन? द ओवरव्यू आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास। नाउ टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट ओनली इफ स्टेटमेंट, देन वी विल गो टू लूप वन। सो इफ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पाइथन इज यूज्ड टू एक्सिक्यूट स्टेटमेंट्स बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट? बेस्ड ऑन conditions, right? So it tests the condition, and if the condition is true, it performs certain action, and we can also provide action for false situation as well. Okay, like we have given some condition, if condition we have given, and if we if this condition satisfy, then we'll get some output regarding the statement. Otherwise, we'll get some other statement. Okay, so this is all about the if. Now in if there are many forms. Okay, if without false statement, like only if, we'll get only the true statement, we won't get the false one. Next, if with else. If with else means if the condition is true, then we'll get some conditions or some output. Otherwise, that otherwise is considered as what? Else. Okay, else we'll get the false statement or false condition. Next, if with elif. If with elif means what? If the condition is true, then we'll get the true statement. Elif means what? Else. Another condition applied. Okay, else. Elif means else. Another condition applied, and that condition will be checked. If that condition is true, then we'll get the output. Otherwise, false. And the first if one also will get the false statement. If we have got the true statement, otherwise the condition applied, then true, then false. This is what if with elif. Next, nested if means under if we'll get another if, then another if, and after that we'll get the false statement. We'll have a look one by one. The flow chart you could be able to understand in a more graphical manner. So see. See here, simple if, like without else statement or without the false statement. In the simplest form, if statement in Python checks the condition and execute the statement if the condition is true, and do nothing if the condition is false. Syntax for that, if condition, then we put what? Colon. Then we may have statement one, or there may be many statements. Like if statement is compound statement having header and a body containing intended statements. Okay, all statement belonging to what? To if must have same indentation level. Means it should, the statements could be one or more, but it comes under what? The true statements. And it in the simple if we don't have what? False statement. Only we have the true condition satisfied statements only. Okay, next points to remember with only if. Simple if, it must contain valid condition which evaluates to either true or false. Condition must follow by colon. Okay, you can see in the syntax that if condition, then we have one colon. Okay, this is what syntax you should remember. Next, condition must followed by colon, it is mandatory. A statement inside it if must be at same indentation level. Means the statement should have the same indentation level, means in the same sequence we should have. Next one, let us see the example. Like see, we need to make the program which input monthly sale of employee and give bonus of 10%. If sale is more than 50,000, otherwise bonus will be what? Zero. Okay, so bonus is equal to what? First, in the initial step, we have given bonus equal to what? Zero. Now we have declared one what variable as what name? Sale. Under that we are inputting some value like in input enter monthly sale. Here we will enter the our monthly sale. Now here we have given the condition as what? If sale is greater than 50,000, means if we have entered the value which is greater than 50,000 and colon we have given, then we'll get the bonus as what? Bonus equal to sale into 10/100, and it will print what? Bonus equals to string bonus, str bonus, means whatever the bonus is there, it will print. Okay, so otherwise what we'll get? Otherwise the initial point, we'll get the initial point is what? Bonus equal to 0, then we'll get what? 0. Okay. So this is what simple example. Now you are supposed to write the program to enter 2 number and print the largest number, enter 3 number and print the largest number. Next, see how to print 2 number and print the largest one. Like we have entered 2 numbers, n1 as first number and n2 as second number. Then large is equals to n1. Now if large is less than n2, then it will give what? Large equals to n2. Okay. We have given the initial one like large is equal to n1. Means in the initial we have given the statement as what? Large is n1. Means n1, whatever we have entered in n1, it would be what? Larger number. But here we have given the condition as what? If large is less than n2. Okay. If large is less than n2. It means what? If n1 is less than n2. Then what happens? Large equal to n2. Okay. So if it condition satisfy, then it will print the statement as our largest number is what? Large means now the in initial step in the large variable n1 has been stored. But under the condition if large is less than n2, then the condition will be changed and under the large variable n2 will be saved and we'll print what? Large. That is, if the condition satisfy, then n2 will be displayed, otherwise the initial step n1 will be displayed. Similarly with like your three number also, here you can see that we have given two if statements like n1, n2, n3. In initial step, in the large one we have stored n1, means in our initial step n1 is the larger number. Now we have given some condition like if large is less than n2, then it will print what? Large equal to n2. Okay. Now if large is less than n3, then it will print what? Large equal to n3. Means two conditions are here. Now if any condition satisfied, then it will print what? Largest number is what? Large. Okay. Now if with else, this is the second second form of if statement. If with else means if the condition is true, then we'll get the true statement, otherwise we'll get the false statement. In the previous one we haven't we have not received any false statement. The initial thing only means if the statement is false, then the initial part will be displayed. Okay. Now but here what happens that we'll give some false statement for that. Like syntax you can see, like if condition statement, this is a true statement, and else we'll get the false statement. Okay. Now see the example, like input age of person and print whether the person is eligible for voting or not. Now see the code for that, like age, under age we have, we'll input the our age. Okay, whatever the age is there, we'll input. It will ask us to input our age. Okay, now we have given some condition. Like if age is greater than or equal to 18, means if age is greater than or equal to 18, then it will print what? Congratulations, you are eligible for vote. But if we have entered less than 18, then it will print what? Sorry, you are not eligible for voting. So you can see the difference between that. Like in the if condition, we have to give some initial point for such that if the condition does not satisfy, then the initial point will be displayed. But in if we don't need to give any initial step, the else part will be displayed in the statement itself. Okay. Now according to that you are supposed to solve this all question, like to enter a number, check it is even or odd, enter any age, okay, monthly sale, now input any year, leap year, this type of program you can solve. Now next one is your if with elif. If with elif is what? As I have explained, like it is a chain of condition or is to be checked. Each elif must be followed by condition and then statement for it. After every elif we can give else, which will be executed if all the condition evaluates to false. Now syntax is if condition then statement, elif condition then statement, and then elif condition then statement, and at last else. Means this one if condition will be we'll get the statement. Okay, if else if then condition then statement, under that elif condition then statement, then the first if else statement or false statement we'll have in the last. So see the example, like input temperature of water indicates physical state. Like we have entered the temperature or whatever that temperature will be there. Now if condition is given, like temperature if greater than 100, then it will print what? Gaseous state. Now L if temperature is less than 0, then it will print what? Solid state. Or else if these two condition does not satisfy, then else it will print what? Liquid state. Okay, means if it is greater than 100, then we'll have the liquid state. Okay, now one more example, like input three side of triangle and print the type of triangle, like it is equilateral, scallion or SLS. Okay, so in the for if we have to enter three side of triangle, then three sides of triangle to be entered, like S1, S2 and S3, three sides of triangle I have inputted. Now condition given, like if S1 is equal to S2 equal to S3, means all the three sides are equal, then you will print what? Equilateral. If S1 does not equal to S2, not equal to S3 and S3 also not equal to S1, okay, then it will print what? Scallion, means all the three sides are not equal, then it will print what? Scallion. This is under what? Elif. And if both the condition does not satisfy, then else it will print what? Isosceles. In isosceles, what happens? That two sides are equal and one side is not equal. So it will print what? Isosceles. Now program to calculate and print roots of a quadratic equation. You know the root, like a into 2 plus bx plus c is equals to 0, right? So see, like 2a plus bx plus c equal to 0. Okay, so that's why it is written a into 2. In the mathematical expression, we write as what? 2a plus bx plus c equal to 0, right? So see, it is a mathematical function. Okay, quadratic equation roots we need to print now. So it is a mathematical function. So for that, to insert the mathematical function, we need to import what? Math. For other function there's something else are there, but for simple functions we does not need, but for the mathematical function we have to import what? Math. Now print for quadratic equation, this is a statement I have printed. Now since a, b, c is there, so we have to enter the value, like a, b, c, what is the value. Now if a is equal to 0, then it will print what? Value of a should not be 0, or print aborting. Else delta equal to b into b minus 4 into a into c. So this is what here. Now if delta is greater than or equal to 0, then root 1 equal to minus b plus math into sqrt delta divided by 2 into a. So this is what? To print the program of quadratic equation. Now you are supposed to do the program to enter marks of 5 subjects and calculate total percentage and also division and number, check it is positive, negative, or total bill amount. Okay. Now next part is, in this type of if, we put it within another if as a statement of it. Mostly used in a situation where we want different else for each condition. Like if condition is there, under that another if condition, then statement else statement. Elif conditions, then statement else statement. Okay, so under if we have some another if, and then elif condition means this else is for what? The first if statement. Okay, and then the overall else we will get. Okay, this is what? Nested if. So for that we can have an example, like write a program to check entered year is leap year or not. Like year we have entered, int any number we will enter. Now if year mod 100 is equal to 0, then if year mod 400 is equal to 0, then it will print what? Year is a leap year, else year is not a leap year. And if year is mod 100 equal to 0, then it will print what? Year mod 4 is equal to 0, then it may print what? Year is a leap year, or else it will year is what? Not a leap year. Okay. Now storing condition in a program, if our condition is complex and it is repetitive, then we can store the condition in a name and then use the named condition in if statement. It makes program more readable. For example, x is less equal to y is greater than equal to x is less this equal to z. Okay. Means like this type of program is there. Under that we can write it as what x is less. Okay, x is less means what? We have stored this type of condition under what? Under this variable we have stored. For that what? If we will store the this condition in one variable, then what happens? It makes our things what? Easier. Okay. So this is all about today's class. Thank you. In the next class, we will see the looping part.